So we are back with packs 31 to 36. 31 to 36. Yes. Yes. So, last video was really good. If you haven't watched the last one, go and check it out.
Some amazing.
Some fantastic stuff in that last video. And yeah. The theory of loose packets, I think, is true. Definitely true. So, anyway, we've got a load of packets here ready to go, and we're going to be opening these. Are you?
Oh, I bashed it.
You bashed it.
I was making it rain.
There we are. So, there's five packets, and this was the last one. So, this is the last episode six, and we'll be doing a summary video after this.
There you go.
Do. Well, you can shift all that over there.
Oh,
bang, bang. This, the mystery of, just keep over there. You've got a loose one as well?
Yeah.
The packets were quite loose, and we had some rather nice pulls from them.
Rather nice pulls from the loose packet.
This one is it's loose, but it's very sticky. And the one packet was definitely marked. There was a crease.
Is it red dot on all of them?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What was there?
It's a red dot, but this one says EN.
Probably for English.
I don't know.
But yeah, the one definitely had a crease mark in the thing. So here we go. Let's get some zooming on here.
Zooming a little bit, we don't want to. Oh, okay, okay. Bit too much zoom there.
Yeah, let's come back a little bit. What champions? Human? No. Ooh.
Tentacle. Our first tentacle.
Not seven tickles, not eight tickles, not nine tickles.
There's 10 tickles.
There's 10 tickles in this.
There's one creature token.
And is this a land or
I
is
think
this?
It's gonna be a foil because we haven't had a foil.
We haven't had a foil land. We've got a theory.
Yeah. And you can't even I am literally Jesus.
We have dude. This. We it's have a, this and it's foil.
It's a foil ray.
We
It's
we've had this already once.
You said this was your favourite card. You said this was your favourite card of the entire set. The first episode you were like
this was like
it's quite good.
It is because look what it does, we've got lots of humans.
Create a human token. Put 3/1/1 counters on target creature you control. If a creature you control with power if you control a creature with power 4 or greater, draw 2 cards and create a gold token.
A gold token.
That's pretty good.
Bag it. Go and check that one.
I'll go check that.
And we're not going to do the next one. I'm going to leave it and...
what is it? Is the next one's a land?
You think so?
Yes.
Maybe it is, but...
You didn't have a land.
Yeah, it is. We got normal, but the foil is.
The foil is sexy.
It is. Looking at it reminds me of.
73 cents.
That's a much. It is. It's very. That's quite sad. The cards go for so cheap. Sleep of the Dead. We've had that one on check in the last video. Aspect of Manticore. No, we haven't. Enchantment. So that's 3 mana, flash, enchant creature, and when Aspect of Manticore enters the battlefield, enchanted creature gains first strike until end of turn, and it gains +2/+0. What?
Oh, I just put a hand sanitizer on, and I forgot I have a cut on my hand.
Don't.
That is an epic dough now.
Traveler's Amulet.
Did you
deliver
the basic land card?
This is the card that was left with. This is the last card. We played the game today. We played a game, and I was being knocked down by his powerful blue deck, which kept taking away, kept making me put 12, 14 cards into the graveyard on each turn, and I was left with one card, and it was this one. This was my last card. I took it off the deck, and I couldn't do anything with it because you can see what it does. Absolutely nothing. Completely and utterly
it's
useless.
It's your fixings in multicolored decks. That's all it's
good if it isn't your last card.
No, it's good if it isn't your last card. It's like your first
yeah,
card.
It's good if it isn't your last card.
Starland, all we got, right? We got that stuff, you know. We haven't got this one. What we do.
Irrelevant Revelers. Have we done this one?
Yes, we have. I'll be right back, man. Or not.
Alexa.
Wagwan.
Alexa. Alexa. Lights off.
Sick.
There we are. Voracious Typhoon.
Typhoon.
Typhoon. Typhoon, yeah.
4444.
4444.
4-7. And it exiles four of the creatures when you escape it. It enters the battlefield with 3/1/1s on it. Triumphant Surge.
Triumphant Surge.
So Reaper of Mogus.
We've done that one.
Yep. Omen of the Sea.
We've done that one.
Vassa. Faragus Spawn.
And we've had that one, I think.
Yes, we have. Like, is that release or is that moving? I think I have a good one at the end.
I hope so.
Okay.
She's all of a wobble. Pop you.
Oh, she's a bit more awake now.
Come on, go on, cut you down.
Can we finish this one off?
Well, finish this one off.
Okay.
Here we are.
That's
not it. We've had that one though.
Do you want to go?
Here it is.
Is it Dalagos again? Can I have a Dalagos? Can I have a Dalagos, please?
Oh, what is this?
Is it Dalagos? We've already pulled it.
Have we?
Yeah.
Does that mean I got two?
Yeah, it means you got two.
That means I've got two.
Yeah.
I think we'll have to do some trading. Good first deck, good start. Definitely.
My theory comes into play once again. She was about to fall asleep, wasn't it?
Come on.
Daddy and Hassan.
Okay, yeah.
Alright, are you gonna have a snuggle bug?
Beef cornered.
Whilst, she's asleep already.
Yes.
She's very, very tired. Like, tired little child. That was too easy to open.
It was
very loose.
So, that's the first pack. And we've had.
Sator.
Two.
Island. It's not that good, but a favorite YouTuber of ours, Bad Boy Gaming, said it was quite good in one of his vids, I believe. 2-3, Stampede Rider, Omen of the Hunt, Pyo Wayfarer, a Discordant Piper, Witness of Tomorrows, Infuriate, Scholar Grove Dancer, Daybreak Chimera, Temple Thief, Triton Wave Rider, Triumph of Annex, Maya Triton, Skimmer Wing Chimera. This is the new one. It's a 3-2 for full. It has flying. At the beginning of your upkeep, return one target enchantment you control to its owner's hand. We might have had that one already. Nightmare Shepherd. It's a 4/4 for full with flying. When a non-token
should, when another non-token creature you control dies, you may exile it. If you do, create a token that's a copy of that creature, except it's a 1/1 and is a nightmare in addition to its other types. So very good card. If you've got 1/1s that are unblockable, and you don't want them to die, so you can use this card to help them live on. So yeah, I think I'll move into place. Yeah, so good card.
We
got a Nightmare Shepherd. Alright, so a lot of noise. I think you might hear the microwave in a couple of seconds. You'll hear the baby crying. I am extremely sorry for this. I think I'll move on to the next pack. Yeah, so good rare. Good rare there. Good pulls from the theory. The theory set seems to be working. I don't know if this is for every set or just this set, but I believe it's for every set. Which one's feeling? Which one are we feeling? I'm feeling this one. Okay, so Hiya, Pop. No, with a collector's booster, does it mean we have a collector's booster? Goat. A goat token. Just looked at the pack. No, it doesn't. Okay. So, Aedalon of Philosophy, Arena Trickster, Plummet, Nyxborn Courser, Nyxborn Marauder, Ichthyomorphosis, Irreverent Revelers. These are all stuff we've got. Relentless Pursuit, Dreadful Apathy, Underworld Fires is a good one, Stinging Lionfish, Hydra's Growth. Before we get into the last card, there's our we got another foil rare.
What?
We got another foil rare.
Whoa. So what was the card we had in the last? Whoa, deck.
You almost went again.
What's this? Nightmare Shepherd.
No, that was the last thing. Yeah, that was the last one.
Yeah, but I didn't see it because he was.
So we got a Plains and Eidolon of Obstruction.
What's that?
I got Hydra's Growth, which is, you said you like this one. Hydra's Growth, it's a battlefield, put a +1/+1 counter on enchanted creature. At the beginning of your upkeep, double the number of +1/+1 counters on target, on enchanted creature. That's a really good card. And we have Storm's Wrath. So this is kind of a board wipe for things with 4 toughness and planeswalkers with 4 loyalty. Storm's Wrath deals 4 damage to each creature and each planeswalker. It's a 4 mana sorcery. An Eidolon of Obstruction. The first strike is a 2/1 for 2. Loyalty abilities of planeswalkers your opponents control cost 1 more to activate.
Is that a foil?
Yeah, it's foil.
Wow.
We've already pulled one of them.
Look at that. Not a foil, though.
Not a foil. Do you want to go check the price, or we say?
No. Hydra's Growth.
Yeah.
And this was from the last one. I missed that one. Nightmare Shepherd. Have we had it? 4/4? 4/4. Flying with any other non-token creature you control dies, you may exile it. I don't get that one. Anyway, let's crack open these there. Another packet. Love the foil. Ooh.
Pillar of Obstruction in foil is 78 cents.
Ridiculous. This is super hard.
I think the super hard ones are up this place.
I think the super hard
ones. Factory made. By machine.
Okay, so no shit.
You've had that.
Is this
past couple? Oil. You're gonna peek at the rear, or what are we up to?
Am I gonna peek at the rear? I'm gonna peek at the rear.
I saw the rear. What? I saw the rear in the camera. Yeah.
You only saw one of them.
You can't have two rays in a pack unless there's foil. And we just pulled a land from the back, meaning there's no foil. Don't try and mess with me, Chunk. I know your games.
Okay, there. We had that one. We had that one. We had that. Yeah, go check the other videos, because we've had these before.
We've had most of these. Go see what we pulled, the rays and stuff in those.
We've had Fruit of Taser. And Old Charger. We've had that in, what do they call it?
Oh, we had that in foil.
Foil, that's right. You were cheating. How are you looking at the...
I looked at the next pack.
No, you don't. You don't.
Why? It's an amazing note to end on. I'm just going to say that.
Yeah?
Amazing note to end on.
So I think this one then. Ready? I had that one.
Scuffers Wally the Citizen Skirmisher. Captivating Unicorn.
I did that one a couple of times.
Yeah, feel right. We've had that. You said it was ugly art. Fear of Arrows.
You saw the last one, didn't you?
Yeah.
You saw that one.
Yeah.
Yeah. I saw the white one.
Have you seen the saga?
You seen that one?
So the saga, Elspeth Conquers Death. Okay. The Birth of Melitus. What a beauty.
What a pack.
Annex Hardened in the Forge. Constellation Art.
Lush.
Beauty.
Stunning card.
Two sleeves for that, good sir.
Two sleeves.
You might need two sleeves for this one.
You were just looking them off camera.
I'm looking them off camera because they're good cards.
Well, there we go. That is definitely looks good.
I know I shouldn't be doing this. I'm probably gonna get a.
Was the other saga? Was the other saga a rare? No.
Yeah, I wrote first. I wrote
that one there.
No. That's an
right. So let's just look at these again.
Equal power equal to your devotion to red. Whenever an annex or another non-corruption creature dies, create a 1/1 Sata token. This creature can't block. If the creature has power 4 or greater, create 2 of those tokens instead. So every time something dies, I think you should build a deck around each of the demigods.
Vave, and it is only 3 to come out.
With devotion.
Yeah. Good.
So our next pack.
Deal. This is the last one.
This is the last one.
What?
The last one, but I thought this would be the ending note. This would be really good if it was the ending one.
Oh wow.
Oh no, you spoiled it. Sentinel's Eyes. Farrakhan's Liberation. Towering Wave Mystic. Good card. Important betrayal.
Squared it up. You don't want to see wonky words.
Mogus's favor. Bronze sword.
I like that artwork on that one.
Riptide.
Ooh, dude.
Is Nemo's best friend.
Dude.
Underworld Rage Hound. Nylia's Hunt Master. Hero of the Pride. Chainweb Arcane.
I can't remember seeing it. Read me it.
Right. You've just done this to slip down, haven't you? 1-2 for 1 as reach, and when it enters the battlefield, it deals damage equal to the power of target creature with flying and opponent controls. As escape for 5 and exile 4 other cards from graveyard. Chain wave escapes with 3 plus 1 counters on it.
Yeah, that reminds me.
Blood Aspirant. Elspeth's Nightmare.
What's that?
Ready for this last card?
Elspeth's Nightmare.
Yeah.
That's nice as well. So, yeah. Oh, it's only there.
Ready for this?
Let's have a look. Ooh. Ooh.
Polychronos.
Looks.
Unchained.
Doesn't look like it does a lot.
Legendary creature, zombie hydra,
not for four.
Zombie hydra, it's a mythic.
It's a mythic. So let's read it.
Enters the battlefield.
Let's read it.
Stop the music. Big text. Right. It enters the battlefield with 6 plus 1 counters on it. It escapes with 12 plus 1 counters on it instead. If damage would be dealt to Polychronos, whilst it has a plus one counter on it, prevent that damage and remove that many plus one counters from it. Pay 3. Polychronos fights another creature, another target creature. Escape for 6. Exile 6 other cards from your graveyard. And it comes in with 12 counters on it. That is stupidly good. Do you know how good that is?
So, let's break this down slowly then.
I'm going to go find the price, so don't worry about you. You need to try and make sense of it.
Okay. So, it enters a battlefield. It costs 4 to cast. Enters with 6 plus 1 counters on it. It escapes with 12 plus 1 counters on it instead. If damage would be dealt to this while it has a plus one counter on it, prevent that damage and remove that many plus one counters from it.
But you can add extra plus one counters on it, like with Black Blade Reforged.
So, 12.
Yeah.
Escapes with 12. Escapes.
So when it ends in the graveyard, you get it back, you pay his escape cost, and you exile 6 other cards.
So, you checked it out.
$2.50.
$2.50.
I mean, that's better than the other ones, isn't it?
It is, but that is a...
killer card.
Yeah. And a mythic.
It's better than Commander, I think.
Mythic.
Because it prevents damage. You can block it and you prevent the damage. So if I have something with Trample that's overpowering you, you can just play that. I'm going to sleep that up.
So, that was the penultimate pack, but hopefully...
this will be the ultimate one.
Well, ultimate.
I've lost them all today, if you want to choose anything.
It could be the last one. So, look.
I need a chiropractor.
Get on your knees, I should chop your head off. So,
a core layer of behemoths.
It's going to be a case of, is this going to be one or two? It was a little loose. Human soldier.
What is a good sign?
Good sign. Never a good sign. Swamp. So we're probably only going to get one decent thing from this now then.
It depends. It might have a demigod in it. Don't
We have had this.
Plenty of times.
Yes. Moss Viper.
Good God.
1/1, but it has Death Touch.
1/1 for 1 with Death Touch.
Yeah. Nice quick kill. Memory Drain. Counter target spell. For 4. Ooh.
Have we? Big boy bronze owl.
Have we?
Yeah,
1/3. Oh, and we'll charge another one. We've had a couple of them. Vexing Gull. I think we've had some of them. Flash and Flay in.
Let's go for Swally, though.
I think we've had that as well.
Uh-huh. Warrior
Blessing. Okay, so let's read this one through. Costs 2. Enchant creature you control. When it enters the battlefield, a creature fights up to 1 target creature you don't control. And get +0/+2.
Oh, look at this one. Got it.
We've got that. Funeral Rites.
Yep, got it.
Yeah, that's a weird looking card. Weird art.
Nation won't get all. We might have it.
I don't think.
I think.
2/2 for 2. At the beginning of your turn, you control another creature with a power 4 or greater, put a +1/+1 on it.
I think it's on the top of a scorpion stinger.
Land.
That's Field of Ruin. It's an uncommon land.
What?
Uncommon land, Field of Ruin.
Uncommon.
I saw Legendary Borders.
It's not.
I think I did. I saw Legendary Borders. Enchantment. It should be Legendary Enchantment. I'm pretty sure I saw Legendary Borders. Outside of Life's Bounty. It's a 1/1 for 1.
We've got this one.
Life Link. We have.
1/1 for 1.
It's pay 1, sacrifice it, target creature.
That's what we'll do. All we'll do on these videos is argue that we haven't or have seen it.
We have seen it, I swear. Go back and watch it. We'll
I'll go back and watch them all.
Target creature and or enchantment you control has protection from the colour of your choice until end of turn. So you saw the back card as well, didn't you?
I did.
You did.
What's it going to be?
Oh, I know what it is. Hold on. I'll try and name it. I think it's Clothis, and that would be an amazing note to end on.
What?
Clothis, God of Destiny. Well,
yeah. What?
Clothis, God of Destiny.
Why?
Because it's green as an enchantment creature. Let's go!
Mythical.
Let's go!
Mythical, and it's God.
Oh.
It is. See that there? It's God. That is. What is it? What is it?
It's God.
It is God. God of Destiny.
Indestructible. 4/5 for 3. As long as your devotion to green is less than 7, Clothis isn't a creature. At the beginning of your pre-combat main phase, exile target card from the graveyard. If it was land, add green or red. Otherwise, you gain 2 life, and Clothis deals 2 damage to an opponent. Can we just appreciate this card?
Let's break this down. Let's break this down.
Do we break it in half? I'll break it down.
Break it in half.
I really hit my finger on a clap then.
Indestructible.
So it can't be... cards that say destroy it, don't destroy it. As long as your devotion to red is less than 7...
Red and green. So combined, or each.
Red and green is less than 7, isn't the creature.
Is it a total, or is it...
I think it's combined.
Right.
Otherwise, there'd be too much.
So, if it's less than 7...
It isn't a creature.
It can't be attacked as a creature.
If it's less than 7, Clothis isn't a creature.
So that means if somebody else has got target creature for...
but there is a
attack.
Card, there is a card that says destroy artifacts or destroy artifacts.
But it's not an artifact, is it?
Sorry, enchantments.
Oh, it's an enchantment creature, yeah.
And at the beginning of your pre-combat main phase, this happens whether it's a creature or enchantment or enchantment creature. Exile target card from the graveyard if it was a land from a graveyard. So it can be anyone's graveyard. If there's a land in someone's graveyard, exile it. And you gain
2 life.
You gain red or green. And then if it wasn't a land, you gain 2 life. And Clothish deals 2 damage to each opponent. That's amazing.
So you're gonna access target card, so it would be best not to get land if you don't need land.
If you don't need the mana, you can just deal the damage, gain the life. That's OP. I think you should build a deck around that.
It is.
Is it good? Do you have extra vision? Because this was an amazing pack.
This was. I wonder if the other box is going to be the same.
This last episode was the best one we've shot, I think. Alright, up there. It doesn't matter if it's got the least rares in. The value of the rares.
So we've had 2, 3, 4... 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 swords.
Oh, no,
it was joint lowest for 3 other packs.
It was on par with it.
But yeah, that means we've had 58. I think it's 58.
38 packs, 58 good cards. So it's slightly better than the core set.
Well, it's an extra 10, pretty much.
Yeah.
Extra 9. Yeah, so that was that box, but we do have
a second box of Theros.
You can't see it there, so we'll have to
zoom out. But we need to zoom
back here. Yeah, so we'll get back to you. So we have another Theros box, which I bought at the same time, same place. Hopefully, we have the same luck, and we'll probably have same sort of cards as well. We can go through it a bit quicker. You can skip the.
We did 12 per episode.
Size. But in between that, before then, we will be doing.
I think
Throne of Eldraine next.
Yeah, we'll do Eldraine.
So we'll do an Eldraine box, and then we'll do another Theros, and we'll finish.
Don't finish with it.
On.
Oh, okay.
Rivals of Exile. So we'll get to that, and by the time we've done that, hopefully, the new box will be out.
Ikoria, Layer of Behemoths.
So yeah, that would be super cool.
Should I take some of our time up? It doesn't matter, because we're here for every night, I think. Because of coronavirus.
Yeah, so don't forget, you can message us on Facebook. Make sure you like and subscribe. Give a thumbs up to the videos. Go back and look at all the videos. Comment what you think of the videos, comment what you'd like to see, and yeah, just enjoy what we are putting out, and we are enjoying doing it, we enjoy playing the magic, and yeah, stay tuned, and we'll be doing a summary of this anyway, so catch you on the flip side.
See ya.
Adios.